So let's talk about what else is not working. Yesterday's legacy architectures. These architectures were not built for AI. They're built for traditional workloads, web servers, basic computing. Not the massive throughput that AI demands. The real bottleneck is the CPU. We need greater CPU density, greater I/O density to keep these GPUs and other accelerators fed. It's not just suboptimal, it's unsustainable. And you can follow here with the NVIDIA journey that they've been on as a leader in AI. And you see in pre-2020, NVIDIA leveraged standardized commodity servers. In 2020, they introduced their DGX, customized servers. But that wasn't enough. So actually, in GTC 2021, when we were all watching Jensen's keynote from his kitchen while we were working from home, he talked about what modern AI infrastructure looks like. Leveraging our Neoverse Grace and creating a balanced system with tight coupling of CPU, GPU, and DPU. 25x what was possible before. This is how you scale. And you can see it today with NVIDIA moving to Grace Blackwell and their Vera Rubin AI cluster, all built upon tight coupled AI computing with GPU compute. And as Jensen says, AI factories are the future, and ARM is at the core of this. But again, it's not just NVIDIA. You can see our clear trend of custom silicon being co-designed for AI, whether that be AWS, whether that be Google, whether that be Microsoft. The only way to meet the performance, efficiency, and scalability demands of AI. What's powering all this? ARM. And this is why we can say, by the end of this year, we believe that 50% of new devices shipped to hyperscalers will be ARM-based. That's pretty cool. But no one just builds models for the sake of building models. And that's where AI inference comes in. So if you look at the computing requirements to build one of these foundation models, in this year, it's taking about 10 to the 25th or 10 to the 26th flops. That is an incredible amount of compute. But the reality is that unless you're selling training silicon, memory, or maybe power to data centers, the intelligence monetization happens through inference, not training. Now, if we look at what kind of computing requirements are there for one of those inference workloads, so let's talk about a large language model chop output. You're talking about something between 10 to the 14th or 10 to the 15th flops. Okay? Now, that's a delta of 10 to the 11th. 10 to 11 is a very big number. And let me give you a little bit of perspective here. The number of worldwide searches that happen any day on the internet is approximately 10 to the 10th. So it basically says that it will take you 10 days of using the model for every search that's done on the internet to be the equivalent amount of compute that it took to train that model. I think that's important to give you an idea of the kind of scale that we need to achieve in computing, and to unlock the value of all this model training, how AI will need to run everywhere. The power of performance per watt is critical in so many of the devices that we use today. And arm-powered smartphones are a clear example. But we've been working for years with OEMs and platform providers to extend this world-class efficiency. And when you think about what you actually expect from a industry-leading PC today, it's very similar to what you expect from your smartphone. You expect all-day battery life, you expect a fanless design, you want amazing multimedia for video conferencing and the like, and then you want AI. We see this evolution happening, and this is where Arm and our partners have such an amazing opportunity. Today, the ecosystem is powering innovation across every major platform, from iOS to Windows on Arm, Chrome OS, and Android. Longer battery life, lower thermals, smarter performance. PCs are being designed to be ready for the AI workloads of tomorrow, delivered with the power efficiency Arm is known for. More than 40% of the PCs and tablets that ship this year will be Arm-based. And this is not just about growth, this is about what it's unlocking. From entry level to flagship, we're democratizing AI by bringing it to more places than ever before. And I wanted to talk about a little bit how we're driving this to the future of PCs. So last year, again on this stage, we introduced our CSS for client. We talked about double-digit performance gains on CPU. We talked about industry-leading immersive graphics and power efficiency. We also talked about scalability and how these solutions were scalable from mobile to PCs and beyond. Let's look at what some of our incredible partners have done with this technology. DGX Spark, this platform, 20 Arm CPUs, latest D9 CPUs, paired with a GPU that provides a petaflop of AI computing on your desk. An incredible amount of computing that was only previously available in a data center. Let's also look at what MediaTek's done with their companion chipset, scaling down that architecture to power next generation Chromebooks with tremendously efficient AI subsystems. You can also see what MediaTek's been able to do in the mobile space. Acknowledged by leading reviewers, the Arm technology is market leading. And of course, we're not stopping. Last year, we introduced Arm's Accuracy Super Resolution. This provides algorithms and upscaling only previously possible on the latest consoles. Here you can see Mori running at 540p being upscaled to 1080p. Better graphics, better performance, all in a power envelope of what you can put in your hand. And this plugs into the most popular game engines from Unity and Unreal. Just a few years ago, we introduced Arm V9. Since then, we've had amazing handsets and AI PCs powered from chips from companies like MediaTek. Today, I'm going to give you a sneak peek of our next CPU, Travis. The power performance delivered through new levels of IPC. We already have the highest level of IPC of anyone in the Arm ecosystem. we are putting on another double-digit IPC gain in performance. And additionally, we have our scalable matrix extensions, SME. This allows acceleration in the CPU of AI workloads, giving developers a common instruction set, better performance, and seamless migration across ecosystems, including support for climbing AI libraries. With Travis, we have double-digit IPC gains and the addition of SME. Provides performance and efficiency for AI and CV workloads. We're going to pair this with our industry-leading GPU. It's truly a mobile gaming beast. Draga, our next-generation GPU, unlocks sustained performance for longer gaming. We're adding more features on top of our already industry-leading ray tracing, and we're creating easier game developer experiences via Vulkan and the ARM Mobile Studio. You'll see more coming later this year. It's an amazing mobile platform to enable more AI capabilities. Truly console-level graphics in the palm of your hand. That's just a small preview of what we see as the future of edge AI. With Travis, we talked about CPU innovation, more performance, more efficiency, more headroom for AI workloads. With Draga, console-level graphics, smooth gameplay, immersive experiences. Working with you, we can enable the future of AI, scalable from laptop to mobile to workstations. AI truly is everywhere. ARM is everywhere. This connection isn't by accident. Everything we built for decades has prepared us for this moment. Together, we're laying a foundation for AI everywhere. Again, as I mentioned at the top, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for all of us to imagine, to design, and to deliver next-generation platforms. Thank you for your trust, your relentless drive, and pushing the edge of what's possible.